All right, so we're going to be doing standing dumbbell rows. So we're going to be targeting the lats, the rhomboids, the upper back muscles, and doing it standing is going to get us into, we're going to place ourselves into that very athletic, functional, primal hip flexion. So a very, very important area that transfers to everything that we do and that people just aren't good at. And so as a result, that creates a lot of biomechanical issues. So the other thing I was going to mention is that the amazing thing is that you're on your own 2 feet. So if you're going to train your back muscles and you're here, this is doing probably 70% of the work for you. So this is going to be crazy. You're going to feel like you're doing cardio and training at the same time. That's a beautiful thing. So, you know, as I was mentioning before about those muscles, other than the fact that it helps us to move efficiently in a three-dimensional plane, when I'm talking about the muscles on the back, it's also the housing for the spinal column. So it supports it structurally, keeps it stable, and in that, as it relates, ties into everything that we do. So first of all, let's get our dumbbells. So first things first, I need you to get into a hip flexion. I'm not talking about bending in the back. So you're going to sit back into a chair. It's called hip hinge. So you go backwards. As you can see, my lumbar, it's not rounded. It's not hyperextended. It's just extended. If you look at my T-spine, my upper back, it's not rounded. It's extended. It's flat. If you look at my scapula, it's set. If you look at my stomach, it's retracted. That is how you get the best benefits of this. So as you're initiating, you want to think about scapular retraction and then elbow flexion. The thing about this is that we start with into that hip hinge where we have the good pull of gravity so we can effectively target those important muscles of the back, but we end up standing like this and we're doing our retraction. And so our rows, our dumbbell rows, and that's a problem because we're not getting the benefit of that exercise. So get into your hip hinge and stay there or even go lower. But don't release hair or just don't do the exercise. It's a core exercise tied into the muscle we're targeting. So very important to remember those things and to integrate, stay engaged.